in the segment is certainty, because this instability that existed, because nobody knew exactly if the United States was going to increase tariffs or if China was going to retaliate, that kind of tit for tat was generating tremendous anxiety, particularly among small farmers, small producers, importers of goods from China. And of course, in China, there was concern because the confrontation led to a lot of instability. So certainty, in my opinion, is the main consequence, positive consequence of the agreement.
So a lot of people do have concerns, saying that what happens after the deal is something of a concern as well. Are you optimistic that both sides will be able to hold up their commitments?
Well, both sides have an incentive to fulfill their promises, because in the case of the United States, you can see that there was tremendous anxiety because some of the constituents of the president were beginning to complain about the consequences of this. And elections coming, it was better to get this out of the way. And in this way, the tension with China will not become a campaign issue. And I think that's very important in the United States. On the other hand, in China, I think that China needs certainty too. This idea that tariffs were going to be increased for no reason, it generated tremendous anxiety also in China. So to reduce that, I think it's a positive aspect. And as I said, both have incentives to comply.
So what about a phase two, and you know, not expected to happen, at least on the U.S. side, until after the election later this year, at the end of this year? What happens if there's a different president?
Well, I think that it's going to be very difficult to set the clock back, because what has been accomplished has to be preserved and not put at risk if there's a different kind of government. I think relations between China and the U.S. now have moved beyond partisanship, in the sense that now we see that, for instance, solid Republicans are interested in keeping good relations and open relations with China, as Democrats as well. So there's some sort of bipartisanship that assures that even if there's a change in the United States in November, that these gains will be preserved.
There's also this commitment to a biannual economic dialogue, a mechanism that other previous U.S. administrations had already put in place, something that the Trump administration didn't necessarily take on, but now it's back. What do you make as far as that being a progress in this relationship or resuming these talks?
It is positive because, as you said, the dialogue existed before and it had been interrupted, and that generated also tremendous uncertainty. I think that if they know that they will meet regularly at the highest level, I understand the Secretary of the Treasury is actively involved in this this part of the deal, and also the USTR, the U.S. Trade Representative. I think that to have those channels open allows for trying to find solutions before things deteriorate too much. So the dialogue is very important to be preserved.
Isaac Cohen, thank you so much, as always.
My pleasure.